mammoths are the most common types of mammoths that we had here in Washington, and it is Washington's state fossil. So the goal of this project is to get a Washington mammoth on exhibit at the Burke Museum.
3D printing is an exciting new way for museums to recreate artifacts or specimens that they're currently missing. And so it was the application of modern day technology to things that are tens of thousands or even millions of years old. So it's an additional way to bring life into exhibits that you didn't have in the past. If you can keep all the anatomical features relatively accurate, and then you can recreate that with a high degree of accuracy that you just wouldn't get if you simply had to mold it out of clay.
We will take the bone that we want to scan, and then we will run some test scans on it to be sure that it's coming out at the right color, that we're getting the right imaging that we want to get, the right resolution.
It creates a mesh, and then that mesh is saved in a certain file format that the 3D printer software can take and prepare it for 3D printing.
I think it'd be cool if the younger kids who come through and see this project and see the 3D printers in action kind of develop an interest in 3D printing and other engineering technologies and their applicability to museology and paleontology.
So it's the opportunity for students from biology, museology, engineering, that range from freshman to PhD, to really work together as a team and create something that's going to end up in the museum that could be there for 50 years.
I didn't think I would be interested in 3D printing this much when I finished engineering school, but over the course of time I really learned about what I want to do with my engineering degree.
I hope that eventually we'll be able to scan a good portion of our collection and the sorts of things that people really want to see and be able to look at in the classroom. We hope that those will be available for anybody in the community to look at.